That's two partners you lost. Your partner died. Ah, 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 ah. Dude, that is the best dead scene ever. No! That is the best dead. Alrighty. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, welcome. It is Monday, July 30th, 2018. DSP here live on the stream. How is everyone doing? I hope I find you well and ready for some gaming action. A full day of gaming streaming here today for you on Twitch. This week has a very weird schedule, and so I am going to go through it in just a moment here so you guys... Alright. Oh, now I got a dollar tip from Tevin. Now who knows if it's the real Tevin, who's a fucking another hemorrhoid on my ass, right? He asks, did you mention Laveria? No, I didn't. You know what? I should. Follows and contributions. I think this has been one of, if not the best month ever. I think it's second place right now. So that's number one. Number two, you know, it's going to be your last chance to do things like, for example, contribute to my Patreon for this month and get in on all the monthly events. All right. So let me go ahead and let me talk about a few of the things, a few of the positive updates that we've had here, guys. All right. First of all, we hit all the sub goals for this month here on the channel. It's official. We hit the tier 1 sub goal, which is the 10 years of Rage anniversary retrospective event. And we hit the tier 2 sub goal, which was another Patron's Choice playthrough. Okay? So both of those events are going to happen. Okay? Pretty awesome. And thank you to everyone who did sub to the channel this month. That is amazing. Not only the support you lent, but the fact that we get to do double celebratory events coming up here is going to be really awesome. All right? So if you want to be a part of either of those events, if you want to be able to formulate the retrospective events that we're going to be looking back at that special stream where I'm going to be reacting to my old content, if you want to pick the stuff that I'm going to be reacting to, and if you want to nominate and vote on games for the next Patron's Choice playthrough, you've got to pledge to my Patreon in the next day. You only have until the end of July, okay? So you only have a day and a half left to pledge to my Patreon and get in on those events. Please check it out. Over at patreon.com/darksidephil, it's a $5 or more pledge will get you in on those events, all right? And I just want, you know, I want as many people to get in as possible, who absolutely can, you know what I mean? I know that it's going to be a really exciting event, and oh my god, my email just updated with a million things. Guys, today, the stream stats reset. If you take a look at the stream chat, at the top of the chat, you've got the weekly stream stats for people who cheered. They reset. They always reset on Sunday night. So it's a new week, a new opportunity for a new group of people to step up and get credit for their contributions this week, okay? All right. So, let's do some quick plugs. Thank you guys so much for all of your support. 10 years, all right? 10 years as a content creator. 7 years it's been my job. 3 years it was a hobby before I ever did it as a job. And I really enjoy it. I love it. I want to keep doing it. Your support keeps me doing it, especially at a time right now with what's going on with YouTube. Anything that you can lend for your support is greatly appreciated and will help me to keep doing this. In particular, here's a few ways that you can help. Number one, as I just mentioned, my Patreon at patreon.com/darksidephil. Pledge $5 or more by the end of tomorrow. So you got a day and a half left. You'll get in on these two big events, the 10-year anniversary event and the Patron's Choice event. You'll be nominating games and moments for both events, so it's going to be an amazing amount of power that you get for your pledge this particular month, okay? So please consider it. In addition, there's other perks you get as well. Being able to get your questions answered on my show, Ask the King. Being able to get a private Q&A video made, right? All kinds of awesome stuff. Check it out at patreon.com/darksidephil. Thanks to everyone who has pledged. A lot of people did step up and pledge over the last couple days to help support, and thanks to anyone who already was an ongoing pledgee. That being said, guys, since this is the final day of the month that I will be streaming, an exclamation point tip into the stream chat. You will be able to also bring up a link that will bring you directly to the tips page. You can leave a tip via that method. Now, in particular, guys, right now, tips help me out tremendously. Always in the beginning of every month is when all my major bills clear, and it's very financially tight for me at the beginning of every single month. So that being said, if you guys tip me between now and the next few weeks, next couple of weeks, the first couple of weeks of August, it actually helps me out more than any other contribution. That's the truth. So if you tip me today, moving forward, the next couple of weeks of August, it will help me out way more than anything else. So please consider tipping me in the next couple of weeks if you are going to contribute, okay? All right, so that is it. We've covered everything. Now let's get to the shout-outs for people who have contributed. Sound good? All right, let's go ahead. Scroll all the way down here. First of all, what I want to do is give shout-outs to those who contributed overnight. We've got Infinite55, who did a 100-bit cheer. We've got another 100-bit cheer from Infinite. He actually did two cheers overnight. Thank you, Infinite. And Cody Carls did a cheer and said, have you been enjoying playing these PS2 games again now that you're not trying to rush through them? Yeah. You know, in particular, I'll be honest here, my playstyle now in the modern era is very different than my playstyle back in the day. When I used to play these games originally, a lot of the times I was trying to get through maximum amount of games in a minimum amount of time so I could put out as many videos as possible, get as many views as possible, you know, because back then was the golden era of YouTube when every video I put out got not only ridiculous views, but the ad revenue on YouTube was insane. So basically, you know, the more I put out back then, the better I did. It's not like that anymore. Now it's, I can take my time, put out entertaining streams for you guys, look for side content. Next day and a half to my Patreon, okay? You'll be nominating and voting on the games for the next Patron's Choice event. Do that. Nominate these games. Campaign for them on my forums. Get people to multiple nominate them. Get them to the freaking polls, okay? And get it, you know, get it going. It could happen. You know, the problem is people, oh, I want this game, but then they don't actually participate in the events where you can nominate and vote on stuff to get that game into something. You know what I mean? So, that's how you can do it. That's how you can make it happen. You know, make one of the games you want to see the next Patron's Choice event. All right. Zacho cheered again. He says, it's -2 Celsius here, by the way. Which is worse? So, you're in extreme cold. Zacho is in extreme cold. I'm in extreme heat. In my opinion, in my honest opinion, cold is better than heat. Here's why. If you're cold, there's many things you could do to warm up. You could drink a nice warm cup of coffee or a warm cup of hot cocoa or tea, something like that. You could obviously bundle up, put on many different layers of clothing, right? Long sleeve shirt, long sleeve pants, sweat clothes, sweaters, right? You could bundle up. You could wrap yourself in a blanket. And of course, there's various methods to heat yourself. Turn on a heater, make a fire. You know, in my opinion, it's much easier to warm yourself up when it's cold than it is to cool yourself down when it's hot. Because when it's hot, you can drink a bunch of water. It doesn't mean you're going to cool down. It just means you hydrated yourself, but you're still hot. You see what I mean? What are you going to do? Get naked? You get naked, you're still hot. It really, stand in front of an air conditioner blasting or in front of a fan blasting in your face is really the only way to significantly, or I guess get inside of a tub of ice cold water, right? I don't know, like, what else can you do when you're overheating? You see what I mean? So I think that cold is better than heat, and that's my opinion. Other people may be of the other persuasion. They love the tropical, you know. Oh, man, put me on a desert island with a palm tree and a Mai Tai, you know, and I'll relax. I'll play in the water and the sun. And I love it. I'm not kind of like, I'm the opposite. I would much rather have the cold than the hot. That's just me, okay? Okay. All right. Shout out to Murdoch, who did a 274-bit cheer to become the cheerleader for today. And he says, well, Phil, it's the end of the month. Here are my last bits. On to a great Persona 5 stream. Keep on rocking, Phil. Thank you, Murdoch. Thank you for all your support this month. Again, I want to say thanks to everyone's support this month. You guys were incredibly supportive over the month of July. I mean, in reality, the way you got to look at it, guys, is this. July was one of my best, if not my best, streaming month ever. Again, I can't confirm that yet. I haven't really looked back at the stats or anything. But when it comes to not only overall attendance of my streams, but also the contributions you guys have laid out, it's been an incredibly good month. I got a ton of new followers. More people are showing up for the general streams in general. In fact, if anything, the only reason July hasn't been viewer-wise a better month was because I've been playing Persona 5 all month. And we all know that JRPGs don't necessarily bring in the big views. You know what I mean? So whenever I play Persona 5, it seems like we have a slower stream. But outside of that, all the other stuff I've done this month has been great and people have loved it. Okay? That being said, it's a dead month. There was no new games this month. I played zero new releases this month. So a month with zero new releases and to get as much attention as I did on Twitch is outstanding. Now the key here, the key factor is going to be to keep that up. If I can make what I made this month and get the amount of viewers I did this month every single month moving forward, especially with the new releases, it's going to be amazing. I think the new releases naturally will be bringing in new people, but then we can have this, the other people coming in who supported me all along we could really make the top 10, and then maybe I'll do the top 10 contributions. Well, I can't see the top 10, actually. I wonder what I can see. I got to see what I can actually get to load on my leaderboard here. Hold on. I'm trying to get my laptop to load, and my laptop is erroring out constantly. Failed to load module. My awesome laptop that won't even load my fucking dashboard on Twitch. Quite honestly, I'm surprised my laptop still works the way it does with as much as I've used it over the years. Yeah, this is not loading. Maybe if I go to my actual Twitch page. Hold on. Let's see. Failed to load module. Failure to launch. All right, come on. All right, can I actually see my stream stats now? Let's see. Ah, okay. Monthly. So, special shout out, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my God. It's glitching out. Come on. Special shout out to the top 6 contributors for this month. All right. In 6th place, we had Eternal Napalm. In 5th place, we had Octoa. In 4th place, it was Infinite 55. In 3rd place, Emperor Swaggins. In 2nd place, Aust Mink. And in 1st place, the top tier contributor for the month was the Lord Lamb V3. So thank you very much to you guys who all contributed in the month of July and made it one of, if not the best months ever. I do very much appreciate that. And now what we'll do is the top 10 contributors for today, which just reset overnight. So in a triple tie for 10th place, we've got Norval, Shaggy Rogers, Deacon Moss, and Cody Carls. Then in 7th place, Eternal Napalm. In 6th place, tie between Jeffrey Rudell and Infinite 55. In 4th place, Obi-Wan Kenobi. In 3rd place, The Lollycop. In 2nd place, Murdoch. And in 1st place, Zacko. Alright. That is it, guys. Thank you guys very much for everything. For your contributions, for your positivity, for everything. Again, reminder, if you cheer, sub, or tip, you'll get a shout-out, excuse me, during the stream. It's disgusting. Excuse me. I will be updating the stream stats leaderboard, so if you're the top cheerer... Oh, my God. I can't stop burping. If you're the top cheerer or top tipper, you'll be get up on the stream stats leaderboard and get credit. It's the last day of the month for streaming, so now's the time to get contributions in if you would like to have a count towards July. And a day and a half left to pledge to my Patreon and get in on the final events here. You got the 10-year retrospective anniversary event, as well as the Patron's Choice playthrough that you'll be both nominating and voting on things for if you pledge now. Okay? Josh Hushel and Cigars just cheered. He said, I got extremely wasted for the first time yesterday. 3 cans of 7% alcoholic volume and 3 shots of vodka. Puked 3 times. Never again. Reminded me of when you told us that story about the weed and you shitting and barfing. It's funny because I don't think ever in my life have I drank to the point where I got, like, profusely sick. But definitely that time when I was smoking weed and drinking, it was a really bad time. And I will never do that again. Never again. All right. That is it, guys. Let's end the pre-stream. Jump into Persona 5. I'm in Mementos. Last time I was in Mementos, I got all fucked up. I got to redo all of the Mementos progress that I did, which really sucks. But it is what it is. So it's going to be very casual. The first hour or two here of the stream is going to be more just hanging out as I do repetitive combat to get to the end of Mementos, okay? And then we're going to jump back into the free time, try to advance free time until we do the calling card, finish up Shido's Palace. It should be a very productive stream, all right? It should be. But there should be a lot of time to interact as well, and I hope you guys will. All right, that's it, guys. Thank you. Let's end the pre-stream, and let's get started with Persona 5. Story, head over to KO Gaming. That's youtube.com/KO.
Get that ass banned.